to perform your task.
Hanimutta!
You must become far more than merely a man. Most importantly, I shall give you the means to travel faster than the fastest starship.
Hanimutta! Oh, fantastic!
Ich habe nur einen Namen für diesen Karte. Madlat Mukhtar.
Mukhtar bagged a hat-trick for the German under-20s in an 8-1 win against Fiji in his match versus... in an 8-1 match... Hey, Fiji, I'm sorry, dude. Didn't mean to laugh at that. Oh, that's interesting. So he's played for Benfica, he's played for Red Bull Salzburg, Brøndby, but the most important contribution he's probably ever made in his life is gonna come in the form of being a silver card in FIFA 21. And what's happening, boys? And welcome to the 74-rated super silver objective, Hanimutta, who does a few things for us. One, the fact that I obviously live in the States, look forward to any time an MLS player gets an inform card, and alas, he is able to get an inform card that you don't have to buy, but it is one that you can get off the objectives by winning two matches in the Silver Friendly Lounge, scoring 5 and assisting 4. Took me literally 30 minutes. I got the first... the first game was actually kind of nuts. I was down 4-2, ended up coming back 5-3 in no small part due to Mate Vidra and then also Silas Wem and Gatuka, my two favorite silvers in FIFA. Managed to win that one, and then in the second game I managed to go up 2-0, scored early, and then he rage quit. So it took me maybe, I don't know, less than 25-30 minutes to get this card, and it is a 220 total in-game stat upgrade over his base 73 rated cam card. It is also, also must be noted that this is a position change, so makes for an interesting little card. This is right up our alley, the bread and butter of what I feel like our channel represents. Silver objective card was just, you know, very, very easy to get, was a little bit of fun, forced us to use some silvers, and then now we get to take him into the Division Rivals environment and see if he's worth it for most people. Some people are calling him the German Ryan Kent, which I think is kind of funny. As you guys can see, he does have the 5-star weak foot and 3-star skill moves. 5'8", high medium, but before we go any further, smash like on the video for this absolute mad lad Mukhtar. Smash like on this video or else your rewards tomorrow are going to be absolute trash. Got him. Hit that subscribe button if you guys are new to the channel, and let's just dive right into it. So what do you get on this card? It's an 86 pace, 82 acceleration, 88 sprint speed. So he's got the Erling Haaland Kai Havertz disease where the acceleration is lower, but we've gone ahead and put the Hunter Kemp style on. Attacking positioning, 77 is the exact same attacking positioning as the card that we looked at yesterday, 2 days ago, and we found that attacking positioning wasn't an issue with the card at all. Goes up to 80 finishing with the Hunter, shot power goes up to 87, long shots, you're not really trying to do anything. You're not trying to take pens. You're not trying to score volleys for that matter. Passing stats are pretty decent. Obviously, given the fact that he was a cam, he's got some pretty decent passing stats. The only one that we really care about is the crossing because he's a winger. And then the 66 curve is a little bit meh. But again, you have to consider that this is a free card. Dribbling stats, 95, 92, 95 agility, 92 balance. We love that. 76 reactions. 82 ball control is good, but then 79 dribbling is a little bit meh. 72 composure, again, a little bit meh. Is the 5-star weak foot going to help him bank some opportunities that that a card with 4-star? Who knows? And then we go over to the 95 stamina. Defending, nothing. And then outside of stamina, there's nothing too much to speak about there. Flare trait, so that's kind of, that's all well and good. We are going to try out Kai up top at striker. I've used him in drafts, and he's very, very good. I think he's maybe even designed for the striker formation, for the striker position. And we've got Leroy Sané, who a lot of you guys have been saying, Zwei, try out Sané at striker. We don't have a lot of great options in the Bundesliga outside of Lewandowski, who people don't really like because he's not fast enough. We've got that Kramaric card, which we love. We've got the Erling card, which we love. His inform still goes for a quarter of a million. So the Sané coming in at around 80 to 95,000 coins is a nice little option if we can get him to work. I'm not sure I'm really in love with this card. His 85 card is sick. The inform only goes up 23 total in-game stats, and it's, I don't know, that you don't see a whole lot of noticeable improvements on the card, so I might swerve that 86 to pie, might wait for him to get another one. The Florenzi card looked kind of nuts, but the one that I'm kind of most excited about, it's not Rashford, it's not Werner, because those are going to be like 800,000, 900,000 coin cards. It is this Thomas Delaney center back card. 79 acceleration, 79 sprint speed. Look at the agility, look at the passing, look at the finishing for that matter, and then look at the defending stats. Do we want to pick him up?
I can't believe what you've done to my boy.
Jeez. What does this card look like with a shadow? I'm actually kind of scared to see. Thomas Delaney's card, 89 acceleration, 89 sprint speed with all plus 90s with the exception of defensive awareness, which goes up to 88. Bro, this card looks mad. What's going on with Shakhtar Donetsk? Wait, Shakhtar Donetsk have 10 players missing because of the pandemic? They're missing 10 players because of the pandemic and they're still beating Real Madrid 3-0? I love the feeling of having like a midfielder. Dude, look at Delaney. I love the idea of having a midfielder as a center back. Now, why might you do this objective? Is to accrue the silver cards. If you guys are unaware, last week we had Vidra, the Burnley player, as a 74 rated striker that got a 200 plus total in-game stat upgrade over his base card. So you just want to pile up these silvers so that whenever these silver objectives come out, you can do it, like literally you can run circles around your opponents. And that is why Manuel Neuer is one of the best keepers in the game. That's the Manuel Neuer difference. That's the Manuel Neuer difference.
Ben Yedder regresa la pelota a Pogba. Eriksen.
All right, I know what I need to do. I don't know why I'm running the 4-1-2-1-2. Let's bring on Insigne, Mrs. Kitzel, Goretzka. You know what? We're gonna bring on Barty. Klosterman.
Kai Havertz. Para recortarlo uno. Era buena la definición, muy
Kai. Was hat passiert, Junge?
Kai Havertz. La pelota de Sané.
Come on! Mukhtar! Do the Erling! Come on, boys!
Otra, más cuenta van, otra buena entrada! Eriksen!
Lo salvó Neuer! There's just something about a German keeper in game. There's just something about German keepers in game, dude, that are just different.
Ya entramos en el último cuarto de hora de partido. Esta puede ser buena, transporta bien el balón. Un topo en el fondo.
Gustavo Vansen.
Sigue con la pelota.
Kai.
Era penal. Era penal.
We're going to this way school of pens. You want to know what you do here? We're going to give it to Mrs. Kitzel. We're going to switch. If he watches the videos, he's going to stay middle. Costi is absolutely broken.
Tiene la voce, se va volando. Y sigue avanzando, tratando de acercarse al arco.
Oh, Mukhtar! Magdad! Mukhtar! Oh my god! We've only gone ahead and done it!
Bien la jugada, pero perdieron la pelota.
Excelente pase filtrado.
Define el partido, lo define.
Come on, that's a small dub for me. In a game where we started out in a formation that we totally don't like in FIFA 21, the fact that we were able to come back and score two with Hani Mukhtar is a big, big dub in my opinion. This is just literally running in this straight line speed. Doesn't have 4-star skill moves, but that doesn't matter. The body feint is still so broken anyway that we went ahead. Has the 5-star weak foot. He's not going to miss that. Look at the power behind the shot. Pop, blast.
Se viene Vincent en ataque, avanza y este buena. Con este rompe el empate,
nice.
Se viene.
Dirty. Kai has dipped to 75k. He was 100k, he's 72k.
Muy bien a quedarse con la pelota. Hermosa asistencia y peligro. Kai Havertz lo tiene,
please.
Buena.
Pop.
Brillante el gol, la puede festejar.
Come on, boys. 2-0.
Sané.
Bruh. Ready, watch this. I mean, he's flying. Referee, thank you. The Kai drag back, and then the Kai blast. And then he's getting out of here. He's not able to handle it. All boys, more like, adios.
Aplausos, señores. Brillante asistencia. Lo dejan solo. Tiene una gran oportunidad. La aprovecha.
People just don't know how to react to that. People think that if they pull the keeper, that it's either going to force a chip. But if you can program it early enough, and if you can look at the left or right-hand side of your screen, depending on which way you're running, and you just, the moment that you see the keeper coming out, if you can do a body feint, because the keeper's going to get there super fast. If you can do the body feint, you're going to have a lot of success with conversion. It's my favorite thing to do because it looks sick as well. Like, as you're approaching net to do the body feint, to lose both the center back and the keeper at the same time, it's like the ultimate power. It's the ultimate power glide. I want to say there's clunk on his card, but there's kind of not. Ready? Body feint again. And then the...
Honey Mukhtar! What are you doing? You're not supposed to do that, lad.
What is that? Is that four goals in two games? Holy freaking smokes, dude. Honey Mukhtar with the body feint mad lad. I'm not going to lie. I wasn't even trying to do that. I wasn't trying to get past two guys, but I think that's one of the first instances where we actually did a body feint, where we actually glided past two dudes. That was crazy. Yeah.
Never really knew that I had it like that when a young boy hopped on the track and he bats. Jefferson around and way back, bringing it way back like when Hamas did a mad thing. Let me be real when I say this, none of this acting. This is life on the A-list. You come up against me and me, but that's it. There's only one outcome. Rage quit.
Goal, goal, goal.
God. And sometimes there's only one outcome.
Rage quit.
Goal, goal.
Three games played, five goals scored. A very, very impressive debut from the main man himself, Hani Mukhtar. What can I say about his card that we didn't showcase in the game? At this stage in the game, now that we're like kind of figuring out the meta, you know, pace is obviously a huge thing. The Hunter Chem style, I think it's a must for this card. But if not, maybe Finisher or something or the other. Finisher could be a very interesting option because I did feel a little bit of clunk. I'm not going to lie with the dribbling, the 79 dribbling. The ball control was decent. The agility was the main thing that allowed him to do the body feint. The dribbling and ball control leaves a little bit to be desired. So for that reason, in terms of on the pitch performance, which I'm going to give him, which I'm going to rank him first, I will give it a 3.5 out of 5. I'd give it a 4, but again, for the position that he plays, there's just a little bit of clunk that I don't love. And I don't like the fact that the ball control and dribbling is so low. However, you can obviously jack that off with the finisher chem style or whatever chem style you want to get the dribbling off, which is something I would recommend if you're using this card. For me, I did enjoy using the Hunter because I just love having that straight line speed. I love having the 98 sprint speed, the 92 acceleration, which really, really plays to the meta of this game if you're trying to win games. In terms of value, I gotta give it a 5 out of 5. It's cheap as chips. Yay, more of this, please. More of this. I absolutely love it. If we could have a silver stars objective every week and then by the end of FIFA have some like crazy, crazy full silver squad, that would be absolutely sick. And if for no other reason, do this card so that you have yourselves the Vidra and the Mukhtar so you can get silver stars objectives done more easily in the coming weeks. Hani Mukhtar, absolutely love seeing a card that in a million years I wouldn't have thought to use in FIFA, and suddenly he becomes usable. The 5-star weak foot obviously is a huge, huge plus as well. But that's going to do it for the episode, you boys. Going to edit this, going to upload this possibly at halftime or after the Bayern Atletico game. My prediction is going to be 2-1 Bayern. I think it's going to be a low-scoring game, and hopefully they go ahead and win. But if you guys did enjoy the episode, smash like. If you guys are new to the channel, hit that subscribe button down below. Till next time, my bros. Tschüss. Later. Ade.